Here's a sort of additional little nugget at the end. Let's make this function more complicated. Let's say that what I want to do is find the word that has an L closest to the end of it. So for example, here in Bible, the L is in position 4. In King Solver, it's in 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, position something. I can't count. 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, position 6. Right? And for the others, it's negative 1. Well, we can do that with our find function. So we'll just pass in lpos, and this should work, right? Actually, there may be a bug here. Let's see it in a minute. That didn't seem very good. We got Bible instead of King Solver. What could go wrong? Well, now let's put back in some of our debugging. Make sure all the steps along the way are working out. Oh, look at this. The f value is none every time. Why is that? I could have sworn I was writing a function that was returning. I forgot the word return. And the default return value for a function is none if you don't say anything. So let's try running it again. And now the return values are as expected, and King Solver, which has an L in position 6, beats out Bible with its L in position 3, and we return King Solver. Now here, I had to add in two more lines just to make this simple function. Turns out that Python has a trick called Lambda that lets you make a function in the middle of nowhere. And it looks something like this. Here, instead of making this function L position that returns word.find, I use Lambda, which means make me a function. I don't have to call it anything because I'm only going to use it right here. Its argument is word, and its return value is word.findL. The word return is implicit when you use Lambda. Just to make sure this is working, I will totally delete our definition of lpos and add some new super long this L comes last word, and it should beat out all the others. Actually, it won't. Now it will. Ho ho, case matters. Oh, and here's our answer. This function made with Lambda, these are sometimes called anonymous functions, had exactly the same semantics, exactly the same meaning as our previous lpos function. Negative 1, 6, negative 1, negative 1, 3, but now super long, this L comes last is 16, so it wins. So this time, we saw together how to write this function findMax. We also got a little experience with writing list test cases, where you typically want at least order, reverse, and random. And another good one is actually empty, but in this problem description, we were guaranteed non-empty. A bit about how to do print debugging. Everywhere there's something interesting in your code, you just print out some values, and then you can look at them. And right at the end, a little bit about Lambda. Super productive. I hope you'll join me next time.